Community support is building as Macon County waits to see if Leonardo DRS will win an Air Force contract.
The move would have the T-100 training jets built at Molton Field, where the Tuskegee Airmen once flew. One artist is putting his skills to work to help the effort. WSFA 12 News reporter Rosanna Smith has our story out of Macon County.
Ronald McDowell is a man of few words, but hand him a drawing pad and that all changes.
I speak through my artwork.
From portraits to sculptures, most of his artwork is inspired by life.
A lot of times when I do artwork, it just happens, you know, through the love of what I'm doing, the passion that I have.
McDowell has been commissioned as the artist to illustrate the hope and optimism surfacing with the possibility of Leonardo DRS building a plant here in Tuskegee.
To do this, it's an opportunity and also rewarding.
This is the first preliminary sketch of the artwork, which will highlight both the history of the Tuskegee Airmen and the future.
And the message is that the love for what's happening in this community, and we need the support.
The painting could be finished as early as October, just about 2 months before the Air Force is expected to announce if Molton Field will be where the next generation jet trainer is assembled.
We are now at a point where the Air Force has all the technical data. Now it's all about activism.
Joe Turnham, director of the Macon County Economic Development Authority, says what McDowell is doing shows the power of people in this community taking ownership.
For this to be an inspiration, not just for the T-100 project, but how people give of themselves and passing down of spirit and skill and world-class potential.
Rosanna Smith in Macon County, WSFA 12 News.
Right now, it's being determined if the prints of the painting will be sold. For more information on the T-100 project, check out this story on WSFA.com.